record on many of these claims. Among the most persistent misconceptions is that we are somehow giving away the internet. First off, the United States government does not control the internet. No one controls the internet. It's simply not true that we're giving away the internet, and people who really understand the internet know that's not true. The internet is a network of networks that operates with the cooperation of stakeholders around the world. The only significant operational change required by the transition is to end the largely clerical role that NTIA plays in reviewing updates to the root zone file. Even more extreme and wrong is the claim that we're giving away the internet, and we're giving it away to Russia, China, and other authoritarian governments that want to censor content on the internet. No one has set forth even a plausible scenario as to how that could happen, and the fact is it simply will not happen as a result of completing the transition. Within ICANN, the transition proposal does not expand the role of governments vis-a-vis other stakeholders. The bylaws retain the prohibition on government officials serving as board members, voting board members. The role of governments in ICANN policymaking remains advisory. Under the proposal, governments will continue through the Governmental Advisory Committee to provide input to the board in the normal course of business, and as currently is the case, the board is free to reject GAC advice. Today, the board does give special consideration to consensus GAC advice, and the transition proposal codifies and strengthens current practice through a bylaw change that defines consensus as agreement to which no one formally objects.